Hola gente del mundo, aquí el Birri desde el hogar, que es la siguiente parte de The Walking Dead, en el cual vamos sigilosamente a ver en dónde rayos está metido Clementine. Se oyó como unos pasos ahí. ¿Y este cable? ¿Para qué? ¿Eh?
I got us adjoining rooms.
Where is she?
I already told you she's fine. You look horrible. And you're missing an arm. Go over there. Put your things down.
Let me out! Who's out there?
Quiet, please, sweetie. Your things. There.
This is all I've got, okay?
You travel light. I don't believe you.
That's everything. Go ahead and search me.
No, I'm not touching you. Just sit down. Do you know who I am?
Sé quién eres.
Yeah, I know who you are.
You saw my car out front then. You see anything else you want in there? Not a whole lot left.
Everything was just out there for the taking. We were starving.
For the taking? Do you know what you took from me?
I'm sorry. Whatever it is, whatever happened, you have to hear that I'm sorry.
That doesn't mean anything to me. I wish it did. I'm not a bad man. I don't believe in vengeance. But I've got nothing left. Have you ever hurt somebody you care about?
Yes, of course.
Who?
My wife.
Clementine said she wasn't with you.
I heard her a long time ago.
How?
It doesn't matter.
If you say so. I hurt her so bad. My son Adam went missing. I took him out hunting even though my wife said he was too young. I figured he had to learn. I came back without him, and the look on her face said, "You are a monster." We all went out looking for him. We never found him. I hurt her so bad. Then you took all of our things. You robbed us. I could have earned her trust back, Lee, but not after that.
I'm sorry.
The hungrier we got, the more she blamed me. Until she finally took our daughter Elizabeth and left. They didn't get far. I found them a day later in the road. Do I look like a monster to you?
No.
I'm not like you. You walked a little girl into a dairy full of sick people and let them get their hands on her.
Hey.
It's more complicated than that.
You abandoned a defenseless, grieving woman.
I wouldn't do that again.
The sweatshirt she's wearing was my boy's. You stole that from us!
I fucked up.
Yes, you did.
Sí, no debí de coger
How
eso.
Could you know all this?
You're a monster. You're a murderer and a thief. And I'm gonna hurt you so bad.
It doesn't have to be this way.
You can't take care of anyone. After I heard Clementine on the radio and realized who you folks were, I came after you purely for revenge. But the more I heard about the things you did, and the danger she was in, our plan changed. Lee, listen to me. I need you to hear this before what happens next. I can take care of her. We can have a family. I bet you don't even know how old she is.
She's 8.
Wrong. She's 9.
But...
her birthday was 6 days ago. I know how to be a dad, you know. She wouldn't be exposed to what she has been with you.
No, yo lo dejé a cuidar de dormir y Krista.
No, shut up.
It makes sense.
It's not happening. I'm bitten.
What?
I got bit, and I'm gonna make sure you end up the same way as me. Make sure you shoot me in the head.
No. I'll be with her and you'll be rotting in the streets. Hey, honey. I think this is all gonna work out.
What are you...
Espera, ¿tienes la cabeza?
I'm glad to.
No, este man está loco.
I wish it wouldn't have had to get this bad, but... it's all over, hon. Isn't it?
Just about.
I hate seeing you like this. I just miss your smile, honey. I miss you so much, Tess. You're gonna like Clementine a lot, though. She's not Lizzie, but she's sweet. She wouldn't hurt a fly.
Ahora! Oh no. Ven acá.
Son of a bitch. Just go away. Die.
Me salvó la vida. No es que me cansé de hundir cubos, es que creo que paré.
It's okay. It's okay.
Your arm's gone. Why? That's so scary.
I had an accident. We'll talk about it somewhere safe.
You don't smell good.
Yeah, I know. Did he hurt you?
No. Not really. I'm sorry, Lee.
Cleo, it's okay. We need to get you somewhere safe. And then we have to talk, okay?
Yeah.
Everything's okay now. We need to figure out how to get out of Savannah as fast as we can. Hey. You weren't afraid.
I was.
You didn't act like it.
I know. I am now.
It's okay.
Una niña aprendió un poco. Ahora debe salir de aquí. No, no, eso sí que no.
Stuff.
I had to get through a bunch of them to get here. That's how we'll get out of Savannah.
Como en el segundo capítulo de Walking Dead de la serie.
Oh no.
As soon as we can.
Not soon enough. Are you done?
A little more. I want to be sure. Just a little more.
So gross.
There. That should do it.
I hope so.
And you're missing something.
I thought it was gone.
I thought you were gone.
Thank you.
Stay right next to me. And walk very slowly. Don't look around. And don't panic.
Mm-hmm.
I'll keep you safe.
Joder, está más lleno que antes. Yeah. de su estreno. No me diga que va a llover. ¿Qué? ¿Ah? Espérate. Mierdas. Los padres de Clementine. Mierda. No. No te caigas. Algo bueno.
It's a good thing.
Lee, they're dead. They really are.
You know, you're gonna be sad for a very long time. But you know what happened to them. When we get you somewhere safe, then just let it all out.
Okay. Okay.
Clementine, we have to get out of here as fast as we can.
Well, we can't. There's thousands of them outside!
We have to. I'll protect you. We'll push
no,
through
them. No, that's crazy! I saved you! We're safe here. I locked us in.
Get that door open.
I can't!
Do it!
It was only a little open when I found it. I closed it to keep us safe.
Pull on three. One. Two.
See?
Clementine, honey. My arm is gone because I cut it off.
Why would you do that?
Because I was bitten, Clem.
Please, no. No. That's not true.
Yes, it is. I'm sorry, Clementine. I'm supposed to take care of you. I can't now.
I know. There.
Good. Good girl. Let's go. I might be a little slow.
I'll help you. I got you. You can lean on me if you have to.
I'm okay. I'm okay.
I thought I was helping by bringing you in here.
Oh, you did, honey. It's awful out there. I don't want to chew me up.
It was hard.
I don't know how you did it, but you did good. Okay?
Keep going. We're almost there.
Vamos, men, aún puedes aguantar lo suficiente.
Get up, Lee. The door is right here.
Vamos, men. Estás en las mismas condiciones que Doc.
I can't.
You have to.
Liam, I can't move. This is it for me here.
Please, please, try to get up.
I can't. You don't have much time. You gotta do something. Fast.
Like what?
You need to get out. out of here as soon as you can.
I can't leave you.
Just work on getting out, okay? We'll figure it all out. Don't worry. Just start by getting that door open.
It's locked.
It's no big deal. It's just a glass window.
Ow!
Not with your hand. There's a baseball bat under the counter, Clem. You can use that. Use the bat to shatter that window so you can reach in, okay?
Okay.
Watch out for broken glass. Good job. Don't be afraid of him, honey. You're smart. He is it. You're smarter than all of them. Grab the chair, Clem. Use it to reach in to the lock. This'll be easy then. He's got keys. Probably to that door. And everything you'll need. The handcuff is on the ground. Get them.
Okay, Lee.
Good. You have to handcuff the walker. You can kill it easy then.
I don't know, Lee.
You can do it. Just be careful. Move around the side and jump away if he gets close.
Lee.
You can do it.
¡Mierda!
¡Run, Clem! ¡Get him! ¡Get him! ¡Watch out! You're strong, Clem. You can do anything.
But I'm little.
doesn't mean nothing. You're gonna see bad stuff, but it's okay.
My parents. It's so horrible.
I can't imagine, Sweet Pea.
And now, you. Please. Please don't be one of them. Please don't become a walker.
There's only one thing you can do. You know that.
I don't know if I can.
No sé. No, si me matan con la pistola hará ruido y los zombies de afuera se enterarán. Mejor no, que me deje.
You can leave me. It's okay.
You'll be just like them.
It's okay. It won't be me.
Please.
It's time to go. You gotta get out of here.
You can come with me.
No, honey. I can't. It's okay.
Please.
You have to go. Now.
Maybe I shouldn't let you turn.
I don't want you to have to do that. Sweet Pea. They already know we're in here. You don't need more of them. You had to shoot that man before, Clem. I don't want you getting used to it. Do you understand?
Yeah, Lee, I do.
Only do it when you absolutely have to. Otherwise...
I'll go. I'll leave you. I'll go as fast as I can.
And as safe as you can. Always be safe. Find Omid and Krista. They're outside of town, by the train. You remember how to get back there?
Yes.
Good. They'll take good care of you. And Clem. Keep that hair short.
I will. I'll cut it myself.
Great. Good. And also...
Man, vamos.
What? What is it?
Todo lo que pude. Ya podrá. Tienen que encontrar a Omid y Krista. Se podía remediar. Si se pudiera haberse cortado la mano antes, quizás al menos quedó efectivo de que se reduciera el efecto. Duró más tiempo que que otras. El 70% cortó el brazo, el 72% perdió el temperamento con Kenny, el 50% se quedó con las armas, el 56% no mató al extraño, el 36% le dijo a Clementine que dejara a Lee. Estos son los comentarios, decisiones estas que no se tuvieron en cuenta en las 5 por default. Por ejemplo, en Kenny, que yo defendí a su hijo en la farmacia, que lo calmé cuando estaba ignorando la muerte de su hijo. Maté a su hijo, así que no lo hizo. Se perdió en el tratando de salvar a Ben. Encontraste agua para Doc cuando ella no necesitó. Se disparó ella misma cuando encaró la muerte de su hijo. Trataste de revivirlo con CPR. Larry murió en el congelador de la lechería. Backup. La ayudaste cuando los suministros estaban perdidos. Le revelaste tu pasado. La dejaste a un lado del camino. Fuiste bondadoso con él sobre la historia de Estados Unidos, sobre la guerra civil. Lo ayudé a subir al tren. Me separé de él después de cruzar la señal. Le preguntaste a Ben para ayudar a encontrar a Clementine. Porque te ha repetido dos veces. Ben cayó hacia su muerte en Savannah, no me acuerdo. Confié en ella con mi pasado. Salvé su vida. Murió. Fue asesinada por Lily. La defendiste contra las acusaciones de Lily. Se conocieron en el peor día. Le revelaste tu mordida. Le dijiste a Omidy. Le dijiste a ella y a Omid que se encontraran en el tren. Le preguntaste a Omid de cuidar a Clementine. Estuviste con él cuando encontraron a tu hermano. Él murió cuando los caminantes atacaron la farmacia. Algo debe ser cuando yo dije que no va a tocar a nadie, a Larry, cuando él no fue mordido en México. Le dejaste ser su compañero para resolver el misterio. Le disparé antes de que se convirtiera.
The air is thin, so we'll find a mountain path on down the hill. Meet me where the snow melt flows.
Disfruten la música, por favor.
It is there, my dear, where we'll begin again. Skip and stone.
Si creen que voy a llorar, no. Lágrima, una chiquita. Pero terriblemente triste. Cuando tengo que matar a Doc.
Mark the trail. Take us back, oh, take us back, oh, take us. Take us back. Take us back, oh, take us back, oh, take us. clapping where the children grew. All that we have known will be an echo of days when love was true. Muted voices just beyond the silent surface of what has gone. Ooh.
¿Qué se ve allá? No. ¿Qué será? Son dos personas. Que no alcanzo a ver. Tienen que ser ellos. ¿Quién es el único capaz que le falta centímetros para crecer? Tienen que ser Omir y Krista. Y así termina la primera temporada, señores y señoras. Ya Telltale anunció la segunda temporada para el 2013. Supongo que va a salir el mismo día, digo, el mismo mes que salió el primer episodio. Sería en marzo, por así decirlo, así que también hay que felicitar a las personas que tuvieron la preventa del juego, ya que hubo como un concurso. Que la preventa del juego era que comprabas el juego, reservabas el juego, y tú le mandabas una foto tuya a ellos. Te dibujaban al estilo cómic, te pasaban al 3D y ya tenías tu foto de perfil de tu personaje de Walking Dead. Eso ya era garantizado. Lo otro es como un concurso que tenías un chance de que tu personaje saliera de The Walking Dead. Esos son los que aparecieron, como por ejemplo en la escena esa de Lee pasando a través de los zombies, y también del pelado ese que estuve cara a cara con él en la puerta. Ese tipo de breve. Pero bueno, nos vemos en la segunda temporada. Antes de irme, les quiero preguntar una cosa. De todas las decisiones que he tomado en la primera temporada, de todo lo que he hecho hasta ahora, ¿ustedes cómo me consideran? Eso mismo. ¿Cómo me consideran? Nos vemos en la segunda temporada, gente. Hasta luego.